Hey, are you interested in developing a telemedicine app or website similar to MDLive, Zocdoc, or TelaDoc? Or perhaps you have a unique idea to create a fertility or pregnancy app, mental health app, elderly care platform, or even a second opinion service app? Well, stick around because I'm going to share a step-by-step guide on how to do that and save your money. I'm Dennis Babich, the director of a software development company. In this video, I'll share with you how to test your idea, outshine your competitors, hire the right team, and save money throughout the process. All this information comes from expertise of my agency, successful startups, and top-notch practices combined into one ultimate system. So, let's get started. Okay, creating a telemedicine app is absolutely vital. And here's why. The telemedicine market is incredibly robust, providing huge opportunities for improvements and innovations. Another advantage is that once customers adopt your product, they're likely to stick with you for the next decade. However, it's important to bear in mind that when developing a telemedicine app, regulatory compliance and user security are among the most critical aspects. That's why the development process for telemedicine apps typically requires more time compared to standard apps, owing to the need to ensure following the regulations. Alright, let's kick things off by pinpointing the key elements of your telemedicine app. Let's say you're looking to create a video appointment system for doctors. Your app would then comprise several components: a mobile app for both iOS and Android users, a dedicated web app for patients, another web app tailored for doctors, and web-based admin area for management purposes. Okay, if we delve into the mobile app, it's gonna pack features like user login, registration, a doctor search function, video chat capability, scheduling tools, a history of past appointments, and SMS verification for security. The web platform is pretty much a mirror image of the mobile app when it comes to features. But it's got a little extra under the hood. It boosts expanded functionality and a user interface that's easier to navigate. The web app for doctors, well, that's gonna come loaded with features. We're talking login and registration capabilities, verification process, options to manually schedule appointments, the ability to set availability, and setting for managing their professional profiles. The web-based admin zone, it offers features like patient and doctor's management, verification processes, appointment oversight, analytics, and a whole lot more. Alright, let's chat about building your software product. One of the most crucial things to remember is this term, MVP, or minimum viable product. Listen, this is your startup, and trust me, your best bet in the early stages is an MVP. This means focusing on 4 to 5 core features and your secret sauce. That's really all you need right now. This strategy lets you hit the ground running, saves you a bunch of cash and resources, and gives you a chance to test the idea. And don't forget, a basic MVP that's developed quickly and has users can be quite the attention grabber for angel investors. We're talking valuations starting from $1 million here. That's why nailing the MVP is a must. Alright, let's talk dollars and cents. Pricing your product isn't as simple as pulling a number out of a hat. You'll get to factor in a whole bunch of stuff like quality assurance, bug squashing, project management, maintenance, and potential hiccups. And let's not forget calculating the cost for fancy features. But hey, no sweat, because I'm gonna break down the pricing for the basic MVP features for you. Here's a golden nugget. If your investor contract says you have to have an in-house development team, you'll need to budget based on US or EU rates. But remember, there's always the option to outsource your software development to Ukraine, which can be a total game changer when it comes to value for money. Ukraine is basically the best kept secret in the world of software development. Big time startups like GitLab, Grammarly, and Jubal have already discovered the huge benefits of getting Ukrainian developers on board to create top tier software. Ukrainian developers are known for their killer English skills, heaps of experience in outsourcing development, and a reputation for thinking outside the box and a solid work ethic. Alright, I bet the big question on your mind right now is what features to toss into your MVP and how to sort them in order of importance. Well, the answer is pretty straightforward. Stick with the methodology I'm about to lay out for you. The detailed method I've honed over time is gonna help you nail down your pricing Find the best team to get this job done, outplay your competitors, hit that sweet spot of your product market fit, and save a ton of resources. Plus, it will explain why the app price can range from 60k to 140k. Buckle up, because we're about to deep dive. Alright, so the first step is whipping up a business plan. That's where the modified lean canvas steps in. Picture it like a business plan on a napkin. That will uncover hidden things that you have within just an hour. The order of the boxes? That's super important. It all starts with getting to know your user groups and their main pains. What are they struggling with? What issues can your service provide? And iron out to make their lives easier. Next up, scope out your competitors and what they are bringing to the table. Identify their pros, cons, and any strategies you can borrow and tweak. Your goal here is to find that sweet spot where you can outdo your competitors by creating a one-of-a-kind solution for your particular niche. Now, let's talk about your unique unfair advantage. This is the secret sauce that sets you apart from the competition. Maybe you've got exclusive partnership with clinics, cutting-edge video streaming tech, or a powerhouse network that drives sales. Once you nailed it, it's time to dive into your early adopters. These are the users who will be giving your service a growth at the early stage. Figure out where they spend their time online and find the ways to grab their attention. Give them something that they can't resist. You could do this via social media, influencers, or the good old-fashioned power of word of mouth. Also, if you're interested in learning more about Lean Canvas, I've created the full video. Link in the description. And remember, don't just think about today. Plan for tomorrow by envisioning your platform growth on a global scale and international expansion. Sketching out a clear vision for your app's future in the next 5 to 10 years is key for attracting investors and potentially scoring unicorn status. Got questions? Pop them in the comment section below. I'm excited to help you out and I'll personally go through each comment. And hey, don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe to stay in the loop and get more business insights. Thanks. Nailing the product market fit is one of the make or break steps in getting your startup off the ground. Trust me, it's a game changer. So, how do you bring innovative and groundbreaking solutions to the table that hit the mark for your target audience needs and wants? That's where filling out your value proposition table comes into play. Let's say you've got a killer idea for a doctor video appointment system. Before you jump headfirst into the development phase, it's crucial to get grips with what your users are struggling with. It could be things like limited doctor availability, the struggle to find info on doctors, long wait times, high costs, and so on. Once you've got a handle on these issues, that's where your web or mobile platform steps in to save the day. You can offer up solutions like a full-fledged doctor database that lets users to find their best matches, a trusted feedback system, a list of doctors ready to make house calls or hop on a video call, and an insurance program to help users save some cash. Look, when you keep the most valuable aspects for your audience front and center in all you do, you're setting your business up for a home run. Remember, small fish can often outswim the big guys by being nimble, flexible, and zoning in on unique and local niches. You don't have to take on everyone in the market. Instead, laser focus on a specific audience and go all out to give them the best value possible. And always keep in mind, fall head over heels for your customers' problems, not just your solutions. Alright, if you're aiming to craft an app that leaves your competitors in the dust and keeps your clients happy, you've got to hit the books and do some serious competitor research. Check out the big dogs in the industry for some inspiration. They've mastered the game and you can pick up a thing or two from their user flows and time-tested methods. Remember, you don't have to build a whole new wheel, but don't just stick to the giants. Widen your net and scope out telemedicine startup in smaller niches and other parts of the world. Who knows what you might stumble upon? There might be a hidden gem that gives you an edge in the market. Trust me, this treasure hunt could turn out to be the golden ticket to your startup success. If you need a helping hand, don't hesitate to reach out to me through any of the contact details you'll find in the description below. I'm here to give you a hand and share my niche know-how that could make a big splash on your startup success. Let's leave the competition in our dust together. When you're cooking up an MVP for your app, the key is to keep your eye on what your users care about most. That's where a story map comes into play. With a well-crafted story map, you can break down the user requirements and map out the essential features that need to be developed and launched quickly. But wait, there is more. To really hit your users' maximum satisfaction, you'll want to craft separate story maps for each type of user. Picture it like handing each user group their own personal treasure map, landing them straight to the features they value most. By doing this, you can pin down the specific needs of each group and rank the features in order of importance. This way, your MVP will meet your users' needs and deliver top-notch value at this stage. So, the magic of a story map, it helps you save money on one hand, while also enabling you to focus on delivering the most value to your audience at the appropriate stage. Marketing might seem like a bit of a beast, but really once you get a handle of your customers' problems and know how to shine a spotlight on them, it becomes a whole lot simpler. Okay, so the first things first. You've got to come up with unique and compelling offers that motivate your users to test your platform. Maybe it's a discount on a basic doctor video call, an attractive deal on a blood test or health checkup, or even an insurance discount for new users just for downloading the app. Once you've got those standout offers linked up, it's time to make some noise. Get the word out on social networks like Facebook, Instagram, Google, YouTube, and even TikTok. On top of that, you could build a compact website that integrates ChatGPT and some present commands, making it possible for your users to get advice from a virtual doctor. But hey, don't forget, you've got to stay in line with HIPAA, FDA, and any other local telemedicine rules and standards when you're dealing with this kind of stuff. And remember, when it comes to marketing, don't be afraid to get creative. Keep your users' problems front and center. Always be thinking about how you can solve those for them. Are you interested in delving deeper into the world of startups and businesses? Do you want to connect with business-minded founders and entrepreneurs where I share tons of insights and host live chats? If so, click the link in the video description and join me on my Telegram channel right now. All right, let's dive into wireframing. Think of wireframes as the blueprints for your app, the place where you hash out every potential user interaction and scenario. It's like your secret weapon for discovering hidden or unexpected features. Take this as an example. Say you're in the middle of creating your telemedicine platform. You've nailed the basics like user sign-ins, appointment scheduling, and search functions. But hold on a second. What if a doctor gets sick and needs to cancel an appointment? Do you have a feature in place to handle that issue? These are the kind of hiccups a wireframe helps you catch ahead of time. So, let's circle back. A wireframe is essentially the groundwork for your app's functionality, and you definitely want to make sure that foundation is rock solid. Alright, next up is the UI design of your app. There are a couple of big points to keep in mind here. First off, your UI design has got to be user-friendly for all ages. Keep it modern, but don't go overboard with the flashiness. Second, and this is one a biggie, your UI design should make it easy peasy for your users to solve their problems with the least amount of clicks. Get inspiration from top dogs in telemedicine, rental booking sites like Airbnb, and streaming platforms like Twitch to pick up a few tricks and ideas. Keep it simple and focus on design elements that guide your users straight to where they need to be on your platform. And here is a pro tip for you. To get those creative juices flowing, check out design portfolios on websites like Behance or Dribbble. Look up telemedicine apps, scheduling apps, CRM systems, you name it. Grab and incorporate any design elements that catch your eye. Like Picasso said, good artists copy, great artist still. If you found these tips helpful, do me a favor and smash that like button and subscribe to my channel. It helps the video climb up the YouTube algorithm and ensure you won't miss any business advice. Thanks a bunch. All right, time to dive into the tech stack. When it comes to creating a telemedicine app, this is really important. Picking the right tech stack can save you from a whole bunch of headaches down the road, like slow user interfaces, non-scalable and tough to maintain cloud infrastructure, insane costs, payment and subscription issues, and the nightmare of your apps crashing during high traffic times. So it's crucial to choose a tech stack that lets you quickly spin up your minimum viable product. For speedy mobile development, Flutter or React Native are your best friends. For backend development, you can't go wrong with Python, Django, Node.js, and Amazon Web Services. For smooth web app development, look towards React, Vue.js, and Angular. Plus, given all the regulations and compliance with telemedicine app development, it's super important to make sure you've got unit tests in your code, solid encryption, and top-notch data protection for your users. And don't forget about third-party services like Stripe and Braintree for payments, Twilio for SMS, SendGrid for emails, and even Zoom APIs for video calls. These can really speed up your development timeline. Remember, picking the right tech stack for each stage of your software development journey is hugely important. This doesn't just mean getting your minimum viable product out the door, but also planning ahead for future features when you're designing your app architecture. The right tech stack is like getting the right diagnosis from a blood test. It sets you up for success. All right, let's chat about the Agile process. It's one of the top-tier methodologies that can seriously accelerate your development process. But did you know there are times when it can actually slow down your project by up to 30%? Picture this. You've got a team of 5 developers who know their stuff, communicate like champs, and are coding like ninjas. In these scenarios, basic tools like Trello, Asana, Google Docs are more than enough. But when your team grows to 15 or more, you might start hitting some issues in the road. We're talking about losing your key developers, complex onboarding process, reducing team productivity, communication issues, missed deadlines, and a downtime in code quality and architecture. To dodge these speed bumps, here are a few moves to make. Get in a tech lead to keep an eye on the team and the code architecture. Bringing on board a technical project manager. Kick off Scrum, sprints, backlog, and retrospective processes. Have a daily stand-ups to keep everyone in the loop on what's pending. Use more robust tools like Jira to manage tasks and track velocity. Picking the right tools at the right time can put you in the fast lane to your minimum viable product. But remember, even the coolest tools worth nothing without the right know-how or expertise. Here's a pro tip for you. Agile isn't just a hot ticket for a software development, but it can also come in clutch for your daily tasks, business operations, and marketing. It's a pretty awesome tool to have in your belt. Gathering user analytics is kind of a big deal in the tech world. It lets you uncover essential metrics like unique visitors, user behavior, and how often users are popping in. Using powerful tools like Google Analytics, Session Stack, Firebase, and Mixpanel can help you collect some really solid data. Just like athletes needs regular checkups to stay on top of their game, your app needs the same kind of TLC to keep running smoothly for users. By keeping a steady eye on your app's performance and really listening to users' feedback, you can pinpoint what needs a little work and make sure your users are getting a top-notch experience. All right, if you're thinking of creating your own telemedicine web or mobile app, but you're not quite sure where to start and you need some advice on how to start and outplay your competitors, feel free to shoot me a message via Calendly, and we can have a 30-minute call. Trust me, I'll be more than happy to share some insider knowledge and expertise with you that could be a real game changer for your startup. So, what you're waiting for? Let's make it happen. See ya!